Sajid Ali, youngest person to reach the top of Mount K2 in 2019 at the age of 20. On February 5th, he was the last person to see his father Muhammad Ali Sotpara alive, as well as John Snorri and Juan Pablo Mojo, who disappeared in the winter of K2 2021. I am going to share what Sajid Sotpara, son of Muhammad Ali Sotpara, said what happens during the entire climbing. January 15th, John Snorri and Ali Sotpara at Camp 2. Originally, they had planned to go up to Camp 3, but bad weather forecast and a strong wind hold them back. But same day, Sajid brought Snorri's gear at Camp 3 and back down to Camp 2. While Sajid at Camp 3, he meets Sergei Mingote and JP Mojo around 7,000 meters on January 15. And Sergei Mingote told to Sajid, "Nepalese team are going to summit push tomorrow. Are you guys following them?" It was too far away to join Nepalese team for summit attack for them, as Nepali teams was at Camp 3 already. Nepalese Sherpa Mingmaji said Nepali team were following a different weather forecast provider than the other groups, which shows it good weather for the summit push on January 16, and they headed to summit attack and succeed. But the other groups weather forecast providers showed not good weather for the summit push, so they didn't try to summit attack. Mingmaji added, "There were a few climbers following them and they also give up later on." Sergei Mingote, who is not with us physically, he wishes Nepalese team all the best on his social media post, and that become his last post. On January 16, the Nepalese summited and Mingote unfortunately perished during the descent. On February 4th, John Snorri, the slowest in the team, left at 11:30 p.m. Ali, always fast on the mountains, followed at 2 a.m. Both used supplementary oxygen, each carried 2 bottles. Sajid set off at midnight, couple of hours ahead than his father Ali, since he was going to climb without supplementary of oxygen. Sajid wanted to try to summit K2 without oxygen for Pakistan. Finally, Ali catch up Sajid, and he saw John Snorri and JP Mojo at near the edge of the caravans. Sajid said there was no rope, and together they jumped the caravans. The jump was very long and pretty scary without fixed ropes. This sounds confusing. What it means without ropes crossing the caravans? John, Ali and Sajid also knew about the caravans because the Nepalese team told them about it after their summit. Mingmaji has explained on this confusing that after failing to find a way to pass this obstacle on the Arbuji road, the Nepalese team almost back to Camp 3, and where they took a different way, more or less following the Chesan route. Mingmaji added that right after Camp 3 there was no rope, but the fixed line started 250 to 350 meters above Camp 3 to continue up the entire route to the summit. Mingmaji added that the caravas was fixed with the rope, which they crossed on the way to summit. It means Nepali team and John Snorri team took a different route. There were many caravases in the mountain, and it was nearly 3 weeks after Nepali summited K2. It can be happen John Snorri team crossed the caravas at a different point, far from the ropes. Sajid added there were ropes at the bottleneck when he turned around. Once team John Snorri reached the bottleneck, 8,200 meters, Sajid feeling not well. He got bad headache and more due to lack of oxygen, as he was trying to climb without oxygen. His father suggested him to use oxygen before they proceeded up from the bottleneck. But when Sajid tried to use the oxygen, his regulator failed. With oxygen leaking out, he cannot climb higher without oxygen, meaning he need to turn back. Sajid said, "While I was on the way back down to Camp 3, I have this memory of looking back and seeing my father and team on top of the bottleneck, about to start the caravas, but I'm not sure anymore if that was real or if I dreamed it." It means Sajid was badly affected with altitude sickness, but somehow this strong young man able to back down with his own, crossing a caravas again. Sajid said, "I nearly fell. I jumped and only one of my feet reached the other side." Sajid managed to make it safely back to Camp 3 after 7-8 hours, which is much longer time than it takes to come down in usual. "I don't know why it took me so long to get back to Camp 3," Sajid added. Sajid was waiting whole night at Camp 3, but his father and team never come back down. He reported to base camp, and as base camp suggested, Sajid came back down to base camp in the next morning. When Sajid left his father and the team on the bottleneck and turned back down, they were feeling fine, strong, ready for summit push. There must have been some kind of accident after summiting on the way down. But the fact is, no one can know for sure, because there was not any news from three climbers, Snorri, Ali and JP, after Sajid left them on bottleneck. Mount K2, she tightly hugs our three strongest climbers and she doesn't want to send them back. "No matter where you guys are resting, you guys will always be in our hearts. Rest in peace, guys."